What's up there, creative souls? I'm RJ Martinez, and today I'm excited to share with you some mind-blowing updates for Kittl in 2025. If you're into designing, you're going to want to see this, especially print on demand. All right, so Kittl just dropped this blog post. I will put this down below in the description too, so you can get a, just go ahead and check this out right here. But they just talk about all the new features that they just released, right? Which is really awesome. And we are going to just go over all the new features and break it down and give you an idea of how you can personally use them and ideas behind it. And maybe you can share some tips with you. So what we're going to do is go ahead and click on start your next project. And it's gonna bring us back into the Kittl editor. And if this is your first time here and you don't know what Kittl is, it's a web-based design software to help you create. For me personally, like I do a lot of Amazon merch on demand, creating t-shirt designs or just designs for products in general, if you go look at the bigger picture, and you know, understanding how these tools can help you with speeding up your workflow or making things easier if you're trying to create your first design. Because at the end of the day, the goal is, you know, have a good workflow and create some really awesome designs for people in the world. So if you come over here, there's a little tool on the side right here. There's a few different things, templates, text, elements, brand kits, and then uploads, images, textures, Kittl AI. And there's a few different things, layers too. So what we're going to do is go ahead and click on text, because what they did was release over 130 professional fonts, and it's completely free for users, right? So obviously you have to be a user of Kittl in order for you to get access to these fonts. Headline, you're going to see that it just adds a little text area right here, and that some of the cool fonts that they released are Helvetica. So if you come over here, when you click over here, you can, on the right hand side, there's a little column here, you can see all the different like text over here. So they added over 130 professional fonts: Helvetica, Futura, Gammon, and Vanguard. I think that's how you pronounce it, right? Some of these fonts are, I suck at pronouncing things sometimes. So when it comes to any of this stuff, you see just all the different, the texts that they're offering. Let me show you one right here, like Futura. It's a cool one, right? So you can just get the idea when you click on it too. See how cool it just changes it. So it's really awesome. That's cool. There's some really good stuff back here. So if you're unaware of that, you get access to pretty much, yeah, a ton of different fonts. The more fonts, the better, right? At your fingertips. And then also too, I'm gonna come over here to Mockup. Let me go ahead and click on this. They sent the photo team over to Berlin to do over 400 professional mockups. So you're going to see like all the different types of mockups over here. You see there's tops and then flat. You know, there's a ton of different types of mockups, from pillows to bottles to greeting cards, shorts. It goes on, and look at headpieces. We're going. There's a lot back here that you can use, which is really, really awesome, because if you're designing something or you're creating something, whatever it is, when it comes to any of this right here, you want to make sure that, you know, you have a good selection of fonts. And it's really nice to see them actually keep on growing the different types of mockups. And it's very easy too. Just click on one. See, I just clicked on one, right? I have a little image right there from a previous design I was messing with. And then as far as mockups, you come over here to little see this tool says mockups. Clicking on this right here, they just added over 400 professional mockups. Okay, they just sent the team to Berlin to get this all done. Okay, there's from Comfort Colors, Gildan, and AS Color on the streets of Berlin, with the background settings are incredible. So if you come over here and you take a look, you're gonna see, like, look at all these, from t-shirts all the way down. You come all the way down, all the way down. Like, you got headpieces to hats to boxes to packaging. So if you're doing any type of flyers for any type of businesses, or like you're just trying to get an idea if you're creating a new, like a newer product, and you want to see what you can create, and this would be a really good idea to put a design on a mock-up to give the audience a better idea of what it looks like, stuff like that. So you can see all the different like types of t-shirt mock-ups that are back here. Some really cool stuff. Okay, and there is a good amount of stuff back there. So if I go back over here, the same thing over here. If I come over here to pillows, when I click on pillows, oh, you can see how it's easy to add a product onto a pillow. So if I can show all, or a design to a pillow mockup, so every single one, and go back, let's go all the way down to the bottom and say business cards, click on show all business cards, and you see all the different mockups. So it goes on and on. And then you could download it to the download. If you want to download the mockup, you can do so. Let me download. If I hit download, okay. If you want to add something on there, you can. Let me show you something. Let me change the color here. Let me go ahead and upload a design so you can see it on the actual mockup itself. This upload. Boom, see how easy, and then I can change the background, the color right there. Let's come over here, let's just a tiny bit bigger, and then come over here to the pillow right here, and you're seeing exactly how you can put a design on a pillow. Let me go ahead and download it so you can see what it looks like, and then hit it, boom, Okay, so that's how you can use that. Really simple, really easy. You can just do this with any of them. It's just an example to show you how you can use a mockup back here. Now, I'm just messing with a few things over here on the artboard, but one thing is real-time collaboration. If you come over here, right, you can invite someone to the project, right? And now this is really cool because I've tested this with a few different things, me personally, just my workflows and stuff like that. I'm big on this, okay? If you have someone on your team just trying to understand, like you have an artist or you have someone that's working with you, I'm a big fan of outsourcing. And if you can invite someone to your artboard or to your design so that they can have an idea of what you're working on, this is really big, especially, you know, if you have one or two people and you guys are trying to finish a really cool design. As far as, let's say someone's making a custom graphic, you know, you're going to be adding text to the actual design itself, or you plan on using that graphic and creating like four or five different types of designs for like a t-shirt. Okay. But everything is in here. Anyone with this link, you can copy the link and send it to them. If you want to do that, you can see how I did that, or you can send it through like email and you can invite them over into the artboard. Okay. And they have access to look at your actual type of design. So this right here, it's like real-time collaboration. So you can leave comments, stuff like that on the actual artboard, and you can share it with someone. And if you have any idea or project together, it makes it so much easier. So for example, I can leave a comment in here. Okay. This is a cool graphic. Pretty cool. So that's one way you can use, you know, collaborations and stuff like that, by leaving a comment on the artboard and imagine a little better than this. Enter. Boom. So when you click on it, the comment will pop up right above wherever you place the comment. Okay. One way to use the collaboration board. And then you just hit resolve the comment, resolve. Boom. The comments disappear as you do any edits or anything like that. Now, another cool thing too, as well. So in here, I can actually create different types of shapes. Okay. So you can see how I did the two stars there. Let me go ahead and do another star. So see how easily I just did that, right? And let me go ahead and make it bigger. And then you can readjust the star too, as well. You see the little dots here. Okay. Now, if I wanted to turn it into a starfish of some sort right there, right? I can do so just by a quick edit on that. So, and then if you want to come over here too, you don't want to do nothing like that, there's a few different other like polygon, eclipse, and rectangular, and you could do the same exact thing and just mess around. If kind of like on the fly as you're doing this, you want to add like a little star or something instead of design, you can do that. Another cool feature is that the layout tools. Okay, so the grid system and like the rulers and the margins and the guides, you can see right here on the left hand side. So like, you can mess with a lot of this stuff to help you. It just makes it so much easier when you're designing or you're trying to make sure everything's lined up correctly. You can see how I did that. Just little things like this that they're adding into here to make it, you know, just a better design, a software, right? So layout tools. So they're definitely improving on this. Here's a cool new feature too. What we're going to do is leverage AI. So come over here to Kittl AI, go to image restyle. So we're going to take an image. So for example, we can go ahead and let's just use this image. I clicked on it, see on the artboard, and uploaded it over there. And then come over here to community styles, style strength. You can do low, medium, or high, or you can describe and select a new style. I'm just going to leave it like that and go ahead and generate and see what it comes up with. This is pretty cool. Let's check this out. This is crazy. I can see how it kind of took the style that we're looking for, and look, I put it over here. Pretty cool. Look at that. He has like some type of fungus on him, right? And it's literally pretty good. See that? So this is the original, and this is the one that the AI created. Did a decent job over here. So you can see how you can leverage an image, and then maybe you just want to recreate it. Maybe you just get a different idea, or, you know, something off about it that you like, or you just want to get inspiration to add more to the design. And then you can choose like the different styles over here, your save styles, or you can just come over here and use like community styles too as well. So there are a few different ways that you can leverage this, which is really cool. You can see how cool it made the actual design is different. Green, similar to the skeleton right here. Look, tongue, but here, ice cream coming out. Pretty cool. The green ooze on his head, the skeleton with the glasses on. So this is how you can AI image restyle. Really cool. And then the next one over here is image generator. So come over here. Now you can use a DALL-E 3 or this one right here. This is a new one, Flux 1.1 Pro. And as far as like photography styles, creating stock images, as well as text rendering, this is just a newer model. Okay. We come over here to basically, you know, all the information here is if you want to do a public, private, whatever you want to do. I'm over here in the advanced tab too, by the way. Let's go ahead and just test out like a photography style image. And let's do like a Kittl AI image. Grab one. Let me grab one of these. Let's do something like this. Looking at something like this. Let's say so like the
some mountains, stars, and moon in the distance at nighttime. I'm going to do that, and I'm going to go ahead and generate an image. We did photography. We're using the Flex 1.1 Pro, and then with the aspect ratio of 1:1, we can do 16:9 or 9:16. Let's go ahead and just generate. Literally just building out this whole artboard, just going over everything, all the new features. It's really cool. Look at, dang, did a good job. Look at that. Pretty nice, huh? Let's move this into this. More in this style. It has a Santa hat on the mountain. Pretty cool. So it did a pretty good job creating this AI generated image pretty fast. Pretty cool, right? If you want to go back, let's say you want to do like woman with green eye makeup on. I'm just looking at the one that's in the kind of looking at this on, and red, let's say blue lipstick, short, and blue eyes. Let's see what happens. This is, I'm going to leave it at that. Let's see what happens. See what it does. As it generates, let's see how it comes out. Oh, look at that. Pretty good, huh? Look how clean that is. Pretty dang good. And here's more. Or similar ones, right? More in the style. But look at that. Really good job. You can see right here, Flex Pro. And remember, you can switch it right here. DALL-E 3 or Flex 1.1 Pro. Now I could do different style transfers as well. So if I wanted to say like this Exolotl with eating the ramen, right? Come over here to Kittl Copilot. Come over here to Restyle. And you can see how I'm pretty much doing it pretty fast. Just all one click, right? It says in pop art style, you can see the example right there. Let's say like I wanted to just change the color of the Exolotl. A lot of cartoon, it's like cartoon style, but turn Exolotl green. Turn the Exolotl cartoon. That's what's cartoon, but turn the Exolotl green. Let me have this little bit medium and generate. Now you can, that's actually pretty good. Added some green effects into there, but it did a really good job too as well over here. Now we can see the other Exolotl that we made. You see that, right? So just like one click, you can, you know, just back here messing with this Kittl Copilot, you can see how powerful it is. And then you do like a restyle, but then you can see like the suggested elements that it recommends too as well, which is really cool. But you can see how you can just literally just, let's say if you wanted to add some to the background or anything like that, you can just, you know, add more details to the background, but look exactly, kind of just understood what I was doing and then put some green in there, right? The Exolotl, pretty cool. And that's how you, you know, you can use like AI to help you with the image editing in the back end.
And I hope these updates help you with changing the way you design or do your workflow with Kittl and improve your business and make more money. If you want to see how I leverage Kittl AI to help with the design process of my business, watch this video right here next. Thank you very much for watching. Peace out.